morning and welcome to another Motor Network Resources Travel Inspiration video. Today I'm going to show you something else which you might be able to visit if you come to Malta, or if you live in Malta and you want to visit something different and new. Today there's going to be the first day that the main guard is going to be open. Let me walk and explain a bit about it. Let's go on and we'll get to the main guard. It's in front of the palace. Basically, it's where there were those decorations in Christmas. Check out my Christmas in Malta video from Valletta from last year. My father actually remembers the soldiers from the main guard actually marching in front of the main guard near the palace, Grandmaster's palace. It seems these are ready for Halloween, which is coming soon. So the main guard, originally called Guardia della Piazza in Italian, was originally built as a guardhouse in 1603 by the Order of St. John, and it remained in use after the British took over Malta in 1800. They added a neoclassical portico in 1814, and a British coat of arms and a commemorative inscription were installed later on above the portico. Marvel t-shirts. So basically the coat of arms and the inscription became the symbols of British rule in Malta. The Attorney General at the time was housed in the main guard building. So the design is attributed to architect, Maltese architect, Giorgio Pollicino. The British continued to house the guards of the governor of Malta, who resided in the Grand Master's palace. Since life was quite boring there, many of the soldiers and officers painted or carved regimental badges or other things on the walls of the building. They were all types of mediums to paint, even oil and water paint. Telephone box. British style telephone boxes. Well, let's see if we can get in to see the main guard. There is a bit of a queue. That's where the main guard is. If one came to see the main guard, it's going to take some time. wait in the queue. Face mask ready.
Strategy together with others designed for areas such as Cotonera, ensures the implementation of projects which further consolidate Heritage Malta's commitment towards a visitor-centric, holistic, and multi-sensory experience in its museums and sites. Indeed, the ongoing work of the Main Guard is a hallmark of how conservation and restoration should be carried out. Through it, Heritage Malta is setting an example of the standard it wishes to maintain.
Observe what is happening, and in some instances they do report in these instances on the wall.
Yes, questions.
So if you have questions, don't hesitate to ask.
Because there are other paintings that is more clear. You can recognize other ones that are oil paintings.
Yes.
But here as well, in those paintings, we found that, that there was a varnish layer to protect them. So they were protected with a varnish layer that was applied on top. Then we removed it. So in reality, we couldn't see the painting menu change a lot. It
because
happen.
The varnish has generated yellows by the time.
Yes,
the
yes.
With what do you remove the varnish?
We use some gels, like the one that we have here, or some vents, depending on the type of varnish, because we found out that there were different type of varnish too.
Yes,
so
yes.
Some of them were lighter.
When the synthetic one, I do this in a different
in the lab of diagnostic, they made some tests, analyzed the type of varnish, but they didn't get any conclusion in reality, just that they were different types.
Different,
yes.
Yes. And they were painted directly on the wall, these?
Yes.
And the wall was painted with lime wash? Or lime wash?
Yes. But as well.
You know, lime wash?
Yes, yes, lime. Yes. Just that not all the paintings are done over the same paint layer, let's say. Because here it worked like some soldiers came to paint in the layer that they found. Then they covered one of the paintings maybe because it was damaged and they paint around what the paintings that were already there. Then they paint the wall in a different color. And they
overpainted.
Yes.
Overpainted.
So we find paintings in different layers. For example, there are some layers of the wall that are oil-based, not
oil-based.
Not all of them are water-based.
The lime wash is water-based.
Yes, this one is water-based.
Water-based.
But this one here, this is water-based. Yes, in this case.
Really an impressive place to visit. There's a great view here. You can see the palace opposite, the water fountain, and here there's a group of tourists with a local tour guide. I've never been up here. This is the first time I've been up here. So now let's go on, let's see what else we can find inside. And this place used to be the Libyan Cultural Center. It was the Libyan Cultural Center in the 70s. But then when the government changed, it was basically moved elsewhere. So this is still basically a British building.
So now we are in what it used to be the office elements.
Okay, so this was a fascinating experience. There's some information about the main guard here. This building always had a military use. It was an accommodation for guards and soldiers of the Grand Masters and subsequently the British governors. The neoclassical portico was built in 1814 by the Maltese architect Giorgio Pulicino. The emblem of Great Britain on the portico recalls when the Maltese Islands officially became part of the British Empire following the Treaty of Paris in 1814. We have translations in Maltese, Italian, and French also. So you can read these if you want. Okay, so it's time to end this video. Thank you for watching. Bye from Malta Network Resources in Valletta, and see you in the next video, which you can click on here. Bye.